H.39 coming in at 2 o'clock. So let's just take 10 minutes to talk about S.40. And I'd just like to go around the room and just hear individually from people what you're looking for. Why don't I start with you?
I just feel that if this mandate should not be put on anyone except for, it should go to the general fund, 100%.
Risking a veto.
Risking a veto.
Okay. Oof.
Yeah.
No.
I don't know. I'm kind of on that same pony right there, but I don't want to put it into a fund that you can just raise property tax to cover whatever the amount is that's needed.
And currently, this is all in the general fund.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. So I wouldn't want to do property tax.
Okay. So you'd like to see 100% out of the general fund?
I guess.
Okay. Sarita.
Yeah. I've just heard, like, in the last, this weekend, from two superintendents that I have a tremendous amount of respect for, saying, please fund this 100%. And these, I think these districts have money. You know, these are Chichester County districts, so they have money. I can't even imagine what districts in the rural area, what kind of burden this could, what could fall on them. So I want 100%.
Caleb.
Yeah, I mean, if I could get exactly what I would want, I would rewrite this bill to put testing on the schools because that is the fixed cost, and I think they can pay for it. And I would put all remediation in a grant program with these same numbers. And I think that we could put a lot more money into that grant program if we basically had a, you know, mandate to the state, to the local district. Given that that's not going to happen, and that a get the let out focus is not going to become what this bill is, I could agree to this bill if it funded at 100%. Or if it capped the state's amount at 30%, and it's currently written, I don't support it.
You would just say cap the local amount.
Thank you for that clarification.
Thank you, yes.
I appreciate that.
Dylan?
I want to advance a bill that gets a let out.
I have to agree with Dylan. Whatever is going to get it out of this committee so we can get started. We're not going to know how much we need until we figure out what's the matter.
Casey?
I like the idea of 100% because it falls back on what would the schools have to come up with and how would that affect our property taxes.
I am on the 100% train, but I'm also sensitive to the urgency of this, of our response to this problem, so I'll board whatever train will leave the station.
Kathleen?
I feel pretty strongly about 100%, but I'm not going to stop this bill.
Whatever train is going to get the, whatever, what'd you say?
Whatever train will be,
whatever we can do to board the train and get out of the station.
The fastest train out of here.
Now, I think that, you know, I go back to what Dylan said on Friday about sort of the reality of things. Also sensitive to the fact that a year is going to go by. It's not going to be a complete project. And if there are financial realities to be faced then, they can be faced then. Yeah, I'm not married to 100%. I think it would be a good thing, but I'd like to see the bill advance.
So I'm trying to see if I can find a way to move it, but I don't think that we can do this forever. I think the longer that we're taking to get this bill out of here, you know, the thought is this is a Senate bill, let them find the money. Did I say that and the record was in the room? Take it back.
That's fine.
I actually truly don't mean that. That's fatigue speaking. Okay. So, who would vote against? Okay. Will you put it into words for me?
All right, so it sounds like we're looking. Okay, first of all, I just walked in 20 minutes ago.
So we have our bill, and the question is moving it out of committee favorably or unfavorably. And the question will be, do we move it out of committee at 70-30, or do we move it out at 100?
Who would like it to be 100?
Like.
Yeah.
So that would be our wish.
That would be our wish. Yeah.
What's the chances of a veto?
There was discussion this morning with the chair and myself and some of the people from the governor's office. I think the chances are slim, but available. Mm. And a little conversation at lunchtime with someone in the governor's office was, you know, really, whatever way it goes, I don't think that the governor's going to veto.
Neither do I.
I can't see that. He's put the money in. The issue is what happens next year, the year after, the year after, the year after. Where does it go? So, we'll leave it at that.
We're putting pressure on the 2021 budget, not on the 2020 budget. This is pressure on the 2021. The two positions, there's already 250.
That's right.
That we're hoping is going to be appearing in the 2021 budget. I am looking to see if I can get it to 100. I would like to get that sorted out today. And if I'm not, I'm going to bring the bill back to you at 70-30 to vote on tomorrow morning. Unless there's time this afternoon, but I don't think there is, unless we want to come back at 6. So, who would like, let me put it this way, who wants to vote the bill out right now at 70-30? And who wants to wait until I'm able to see if I can find a pathway for the 100?
Wait to see what you can find out.
Who wants to wait to see what I can find out? Okay. I'll see what I can do. I know we've worked really hard on this bill. And whatever I can get tomorrow, it's going to be the vote.
Okay.
It's going to be it.
Yep.
Because now we're holding it up.
And the bill has two more stops to make just in the house.
Just in the house.
I just want to say, Kate, I really appreciate you trying.
Thank you.
Yep.
Me too.
Me too.
Yeah.
Despite the fact that it should have been.
Yeah, it should have been.
Not our fault.
Looking for the fast train. That train left quite some time ago. Okay, why don't we take 10 minutes and we'll go back to another easy topic.
What's the next one?
F-46. Tomorrow morning, 9 a.m., we are voting the bill. We're voting a bill out. I will let you know if I've got a pathway. Then the bill will, the vote will be, do we go with the one in front of us, or do we go with 100%?
Okay.
And we will look at that. So it'll be 100 or it'll be 70. We do not have an appetite for anything else, correct?
Correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, my request is no surprises over the week, over the evening.
Only good surprise.
Change our minds.
That's our
good
choice.
Surprise.
70 or 100, and it's out of here. Whatever it is that gives me a passing vote.
Yes.
So now we have another problem.
Mm-hmm. What's that? Oh, this problem. All right.
Next.
So now we go on to something easy.
Yes.
H-39. It is back from the Senate. It was on the calendar today. I postponed action so we could speak today. Today, we are going to hear from Nicole. We hear from the School Boards Association, the superintendents. We're going to hear from the Agency of Education. The question will be, do we concur? Do we concur with further proposal of amendment, or do we go to a committee of conference? Those are the three choices. Is anybody seeing a fourth choice that I'm missing?
Postponing indefinitely?
Yeah.
Postponing indefinitely. I'm really hoping that we will not make that one of our choices.
That's why.
Postpone indefinitely.
Oh, no.
Okay. So Nicole. So we had a presentation of the bill on Friday.
Right.
We do not have our attorney here today.
You can ask Luke to come in anytime.
Why don't you ask Luke to, if he can come up? Yeah. Sorry, I should have asked him. Okay, thank
you. Good afternoon. For the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President Neil O'Dell in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H.39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President Neil O'Dell in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President Neil O'Dell in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President Neil O'Dell in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President Neil O'Dell in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony, so I will send you the updated version that's okay. directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President, Neil O'Dell, in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's okay. directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President, Neil O'Dell, in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's okay. directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President, Neil O'Dell, in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's okay. directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vice President, Neil O'Dell, in the Senate Education Committee, and we did make a few changes, so I'll make sure you get that. Since then, the last time we testified in this committee on H-39, we did not have a position on delay. As we prepared to, for the record, my name is Nicole Mace. I'm the executive director of the Vermont School Boards Association, and it looks like I sent you the wrong testimony. So I will send you the updated version that's okay. directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Nicole Mace, I'm the executive director. Association. So I will send you the updated version that's okay. directed to the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vermont School Boards Association. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vermont School Boards Association. So I will send you the House Education. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our School Boards Association testimony. So I will send you the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our School Boards Association. So I will send you the House Education Committee. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vermont School Boards Association. But essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony that was offered by our Vermont School Boards Association. Board Association. Essentially, the testimony that I have on the record today is the same testimony. But essentially, the testimony